Hey guys and gals, I'm here with a new video that I've wanted to make for many, many years. There's a product that I love using. I buy it when I can. It's something that I don't really need, but if I have some extra money laying around, if things have piled up enough, I love to get it. And I'm talking about disc socks. What are disc socks, you might ask? Well, there's quite a bit in there, so let's get them opened up. And here you have your disc socks. And here we have the disc socks. These are what they are. They are little sleeves for your DVDs and Blu-rays and your game cases, all that kind of stuff. If you're someone like me who buys a lot of movies, they kind of take up a lot of space. And I know your big answer is, well, stop buying movies or go digital. And that is probably a really good answer. No, because I like owning physical media. I just don't like the space that goes along with it. Now, there are some people out there who this will totally not be for. I know there's a lot of people who collect movies that like having all the artwork displayed. They buy the exclusive cases with the special artwork. They just like having things like that. And I understand that. I do. But that's not for me. Maybe one day when I can dedicate an entire basement to my movie collection, I'll go for that. But for now, I'm happy with this. So the way this works is you have two options available. There is the DVD Pro sleeves, which are, like you would guess, for DVDs. And then there are the High Def Pro sleeves. They're for Blu-rays and HD DVDs if you still have some of those. So you get 25 per pack. I believe for the DVD sleeves, it's like $23 for 25. For the High Def, it's like 20 for 25. I think it's ultimately a really good deal. And let me get these opened up and show you one up close. This is a Disc Socks. It does have their little name right there, discsocks.com, although their website is actually like mmdesign.com. I will have a link in the description if you want to pick these up. So they are very, very simple cases. They're plastic. They have this kind of lining inside that helps to prevent scratching. It's very, very soft. I don't even know. I'm terrible with materials. I don't know. But the whole idea is you take your case, that, for instance, Heat, one of my recent purchases that I love. I've had on DVD for a very long time. You take your insert out. You pop it in the back. Doop a doop a doop, la da 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 da, and then you put it through the front. Dee 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 da ba goo doo doo ba da ba. Get it lined up so that when you fold this over, you can still see that. And there you go. You already have your artwork. So have it displayed. You have all your information on the back. You take your disc. I will need to track down my DVD copy, and you can put your disc right in the front. There's that. Oh, did I even put it in there? Nope, I didn't. And if you have any kind of insert, I'm not going to use it. Actually, you know what? Hey, if you want a digital copy of Heat, I have no reason to get this, and I don't know when it expires, but first one to use that. Go nuts. Watch Heat. Enjoy Heat. It's a great movie. But if your movie has any kind of insert, whether it's a list of chapters, special features, that kind of thing, you can even put those inside there. Or if you do have a third disc, for Blu-ray, I would recommend. DVD, not so much. You can put it inside there, have your insert, and there you go. There is your movie. And the whole idea is you're taking this and putting it in something like this. So if you give me a second, I'm going to go through a collection of movies that I've had sitting around, and we're going to see how this stacks up. So give me a second. And after what felt like ages, I'm done, except for, well, I'm on my very last one. You can see just how much of an improvement this is. One thing I forgot to mention, after you put your insert in, you will have this kind of bulging effect because it's used to being in this case. It helps if you kind of pinch it and just kind of give a slight bend, and that will help it stay a lot flatter. But as you can see, insert's put in, take out your disc. Disc one goes in the front. Disc two goes in the beak. Both of them have that little that kind of protective, I won't say protective, but that kind of material, so it's not going to scratch it up. It keeps it nice and smooth, and they advertise it actually cleans your disc when you're putting it in and out, and I can kind of see that, but whatever. Now, you could fit a third disc there, as I mentioned before, if you really want to. I would advise it for Blu-ray, maybe DVD not so much, because DVD could get scratched a lot easier. These are made for two discs, but they do have little inserts you can buy. It's like a four-disc sleeve that you just put right inside there, but you could buy any kind of CD, DVD, whatever kind of sleeve, and you can store your third disc, maybe even your fourth disc inside there. And there's that, there's done, there's that, and there's that. And you can see right here, 25 Blu-rays, and when you get this actually on your shelf, it'll be more like this. There's 25 Blu-rays. Now keep in mind, this is Blu-rays. DVDs are going to be about the same in terms of this height versus, and there it is with DVD cases. So Again, 25, 25, 25. This will save you so much space on your shelves. I love it. Granted, if your movie is in a digibook or any kind of special packaging, this will not work for you unless you make that sacrifice and get rid of that packaging. I personally keep those. And if you're someone who just likes the artwork, obviously you may not want this, although you do still keep this artwork. You just don't have any kind of slipcover, which I know some people really, really love. If you go a step further, they actually have storage chests that they offer on their website. Some are kind of like the rustic like travel trunks. Some of them are more what I would kind of associate with what you would see with a band kind of transporting their gear, those big cases. They have those they offer. They have inserts that have lettering so you can just kind of flip through by letter. I have a bunch of those. I didn't actually get cut down to fit what I have. And I highly recommend these. I think they are perfect. 25 DVD socks for $23 and 25 Blu-ray socks for $20. I think it's great. And obviously, if you have video games, I know 360, PS2, Wii game cases, they work with the DVD sleeves. You can see, perfect for Wii, Xbox, and PS2, and PS3, and I assume PS4 will work for the high-def pro sleeves. So you can kind of see how that works out. But yeah, I love these. I recommend getting them. The only downside that I personally have is I don't want to toss these cases. In the event that someday I want to go back, it would be an absolute travesty to having to rebuy Blu-ray cases. So since I already have a storage unit, I just put these in a box and I lock them away in there. I don't know if you want to toss these. I don't know if you want to recycle them, sell them, do whatever. I think you could probably sell these on eBay if you really wanted to. It's up to you. Do whatever you want. But I love these and I would say check them out. Again, link in the video description down below. Check out Disc Socks. I actually need to buy about 2 or 3 more packs myself, so I better get on that. But thanks for watching as always, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it's not the typical toy thing, but I love these. I love them. And keep in mind, just it goes flatter. When you put it on the shelf, it'll be flatter. They're kind of bulging because they're fresh. But I will see you around. Take care.